Like anything in technology, the only thing that you can count on is constant change. So let's begin with the console area. The video console area looks a little different. We've moved the light control board over here. We've eliminated some stuff and moved it over there. The big change here will be we've added robotic cameras to the system, and we'll get into the details of how to use that. This rack is still the primary record point for all productions done in the studio. We can record on DVD and VCR, DV tapes, but this is primarily where we record to still. So this rack still has the same purpose as it did before. Okay, predominantly before, this whole rack was used for duplication and broadcasting. Well, the college has placed a digital sign system into the institution, and this is now primarily what controls the digital signs. You can see the election results being run right now. This is the monitor for the actual digital sign device, which is running down here below. And this is a NTSC preview of what it looks like. And primarily this is been dedicated to just digital sign work. We also have devices for playing back on the digital sign system, DVDs, tapes, whatever, but predominantly it's still images of events that are upcoming. This computer's primarily now used for uploading videos to YouTube, the GCC YouTube site. So it's not really used as a production tool as much as it used to be. It's more for uploading and moving information, because our distribution mechanism has primarily changed to the web. Well, as I said, we have the studio cameras, traditional studio cameras, but we also have robotic cameras now installed in the studio. And for some events, it's just as easy, and if we only have one person working, it's much easier to have somebody operate two robotic cameras than try to run back and forth between the rooms and set up cameras. As this was an afterthought and an add-on, we don't have, you know, the pure wiring for the robotic cameras. We have a power supply that goes to a power strip that feeds both of these, and basically to turn them on and off, you use the power strip for the moment. We may update that as we get some more electrical work done. But basically they're off now. We turn them on. Both cameras will come on at the same time. They kind of do this little reset thing. And then we're ready to go. So let's talk about that. The first step in setting up the studio, if you're going to use the robotic cameras, is to turn them on. You turn on the cameras in the other room. You turn on the monitors. You turn on your switcher. Switch is over here, just like before. And you turn on these monitors. And you're ready to go. You do your patching and you record stuff over there, just like before. The major change is going to be in this console here. So what you have is the same basic setup as in the original video. You have your switcher, you have your camera monitors, you have your controllers, your preview and effects monitor, and your program monitor. But what we've done is added an inline switcher so that we can switch from either the robotic cameras, which are on now, and I'm going to switch to the studio camera, which is just showing color bars at the moment. So using this switcher, we can switch between studio cameras, the traditional cameras, or robotic cameras. So that's a studio camera, that's a robotic camera, and the same goes for on this side. And that's the major change of source inputs. The main control for robotic cameras is right here. And what I'm going to do is hold this close to this So you can see what's happening when I do some of these controls. First off, this is what controls the cameras. Right now, I want to control camera one. So camera one is highlighted. Or I can go to camera two and control that. But for the demonstration, we'll work with camera one. If you move the knob left or right, it's actually a joystick, left or right, the camera's going to pan left or right. If you push the joystick up or down, the camera's going to tilt up or down. On the knob itself, if you turn the knob, it's going to allow you to zoom out or zoom in. And those are the basic movement controls that this joystick allows you to do. Like I said, you pick camera one, you make adjustments to that, or you pick camera two and make adjustments to that. We could have four cameras in the studio, and at some point in time we may have four robotic cameras in the studio, but for now we just have one and two. The other thing that this controller allows you to do is change the exposure. There's a brightness and a darkness control. It's basically opening and closing the iris. So if I press the darkness control, you can see the screen gets dark. If I bring it up, and it is by a series of clicks, you can bring the iris up. Most of the time we use these cameras in autofocus mode, but you can also manually focus. So now I'm going to zoom into this area. And there's two little buttons below the joystick that allow me to focus the image. Now this is your manual focus set. To shut down the system with the robotic cameras, you have to park the cameras. And what that means is pointing them at themselves, basically, so that they're not pointed at any place where there could be bright light. And you close the iris all the way down. Close the iris all the way down. Then you go out and turn off the cameras. Then you shut down your monitors. And shut off your switcher. And that's how you shut down the system.